This is a production of WKNO Memphis. Production funding for this program is made possible in part by the WKNO Production Fund, the WKNO Endowment Fund, and by viewers like you. Thank you.
I'm Amy Shannon. Welcome to Local Color. We have an exciting show for today, so we're just going to go ahead and jump in. Tracy, tell me about the new Germantown Community Theater season for 2011 and 2012.
Sure. They have a great season. Their second show of the season is up right now. It's Agatha Christie's Mousetrap. So they had it running last weekend, and it runs through this Sunday, November 13th. And those tickets sell out really, really fast. They do a great job with Agatha Christie's whodunit. So call and get your tickets because it'll sell out by the end of the weekend.
And then coming up next is The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, right?
Yes, they're going to do that as their Christmas show, but they're doing two different versions of it, which is kind of interesting. They have a daytime production that's going to be produced in-house, and it can tour to schools, as well as they're going to do some performances in their theater. So schools can call and book them, but then they're also going to be running it in the evenings for families.
Oh, well, that's really
neat.
Isn't
that fun? Yeah.
And don't feel like that you have to write all this stuff down. We're going to have all the information on our website, wkno.org/localcolor. We'll have all the links, dates, times, and pertinent information. What else is coming up?
Also on their season is The Boys Next Door, which is a wonderful drama, really, really lovely piece. They're going to be doing that and following that up with The Adventures of Tom Sawyer in the spring, as well as The Spitfire Grill, which is a really fun musical.
And then surprised by how much I love this.
I love that musical. It's really fun, and I'm surprised that no one ever does it. So this is a great chance to see a musical that's not often produced, but is very, very enjoyable.
The movie was such a sleeper hit. That was sort of like, you know, written off as, you know, it's a chick flick. And so here I am going to see the musical version going, and it was fantastic.
It's gritty.
Well, good.
It's gritty.
And that's in May and June, right?
That's right. They're producing Spitfire Grill. It opens in April and runs through the entire April, and then Lend Me a Tenor in May and June.
Okay, that's the cap for their season.
Yeah.
Lend Me a Tenor. Mm-hmm. Stephanie, I heard that you have a new favorite.
Playhouse 51 in Millington. I went there and saw Arsenic and Old Lace, and they had Laurie Harris Yerlich playing Teddy, a woman playing Teddy. I loved it. And their next show is going to be A Tune of Christmas, and that's in December. So.
And Playhouse 51 season for 2011 and 2012, we have that information as well.
Yes.
So Tune of Christmas comes up December 9th, 10th, and 11th, and then again on the 16th and 17th, their shows are at 7:30. At 8077 Wilkinsville Road. And then the next production is Over the River and Through the Woods, right?
Right, and they're going to be doing auditions for that in December, too. So start practicing, get ready for your auditions.
That is in March, I believe.
It's in March.
And then The Ransom of Red Chief in June.
Yes.
And then you can get all of that information online, but they have memberships, tickets, and discounts available.
I'll just toss this out there really quickly, too. Over the River and Through the Woods is a fantastic drama comedy about, but it's by Joe DiPietro, who is the guy who wrote the book for Memphis.
Really?
So, yeah, it's actually sort of a really nice example to see the other side of his work. And as far as I'm concerned, it's the best thing he's ever done.
So, wow.
It's going to be a great
performance. Wow, that's pretty exciting.
Mm-hmm.
Chris, tell me about, now I know that this is the 100th anniversary celebration for University of Memphis.
Yes, it is.
What do we have coming up?
Well, you know, this is the time of year when, if you are a theater goer, it's a strange period, because this is the period where the plays that are being produced aren't necessarily for the people that go to the theater on a regular basis. It's the holiday shows are all coming up. So it's, you know, get ready for Annie, get ready for A Christmas Carol, get ready for
A Tune of Christmas.
And so this is like the period of time where I always try and encourage people to get out and, you know, the people that are going to go see those things are going to see them and love them. But theater lovers, it's always a good opportunity to sort of reacquaint yourself with how excellent our college and university theater is around here.
Exactly.
Because we really do have some fantastic stuff. And the University of Memphis is doing something really interesting right now. They're producing two plays in rotating rep. I did rotating rep in college. It is the hardest thing you will ever love because you're doing one play one night, another play the next night. You know, you may be acting in both. You're probably turning over the sets.
Yeah.
It's so difficult and so rewarding for performers and techies. You grow so much. And the shows that they are doing are Wit, which is a Pulitzer Prize winning one-act drama by Margaret Edson, and Arcadia, which is probably my favorite play by Tom Stoppard, who's a very celebrated British playwright, wrote Rosencrantz and Guildenstern Are Dead. People who just saw Every Good Boy Deserves Favor at Playhouse on the Square. That was a collaboration between Stoppard and the composer André Previn. And they're also both difficult plays to just sort of succinctly describe. So I will just say that Arcadia plays with the idea of time and the fact that it takes place in a very old house that was, and it goes back and forth between the present being the late 20th century, actually, from when the play was written, and sort of the mid 18th century, the Romantic poet period. And I'll just throw it out that it deals with the idea of knowledge, the idea of the loss of knowledge, with chaos theory, in ways that are very dramatic, very funny. You don't have to be a physicist to get it.
We can see both of these because they're running through the 12th.
They're running through this weekend, and you know, they'll be alternating nights. Wit is a harder piece. It is about a woman who is an academic who has developed cancer, and it's metastasized. She's not going to get rid of it. She is basically filtering what is left of her life through John Donne's poem, Death Be Not Proud. And you often see it written with a semicolon, you know, W semicolon T instead of W-I-T, and it's because she's very concerned with the use of semicolons over commas in Donne's poem.
Right.
And you put that out there, and it's like, you know, what kind?
What? It's very moving.
It's very moving.
It's
very
fascinating.
And people who are interested in this, Margaret Edson she's coming to town, and will be delivering a free lecture at the University of Memphis on Friday. I think it's
2:30.
Awesome.
So these are shows that are both fantastic and worth checking out.
Also, the College of Communication and Fine Arts dance concert is going to be December 1st through the 4th. That will be at 8 o'clock at room 124, New Voices of the South, or is it New Voices? The New Voices Showcase, which is really cool. And that event is free and open to the public. Tell me about annual downtown dining.
This is our third annual downtown dining.
I can't believe it.
I know, it's crazy. It was started by a small group of restaurants 3 years ago, and it's just grown. It's fantastic. This year, I think we have about 20 restaurants
participating. So let me ask you this. This is your third year, and this is three courses. So for the fourth year, will there be four courses? And if we keep going, are we going to end up on the 20th year, 20 courses?
The way we play off the year is the first year we did it, it was $20.09. Last year it was $20.10. This year it's $20.11. So we raise it a penny a year.
You guys are just
but, you know,
hardcore.
We're gouging everyone. But it's really a lot of fun. There was a great article in the CA that gave a lot of great tips about it. Make reservations. You know, tip generously. If the place that you want to go to is full, go to another one. We have fantastic restaurants. You can check out Chez Philippe for $20, which is amazing. They've got a great selection. You can get an arugula poached pear and walnut salad. You can get smoked salmon with asparagus and a fennel beurre blanc sauce, braised short ribs with pumpkin sage.
Oh, my goodness.
I mean, it's just an amazing selection.
We really don't need to talk about food.
Yeah, I know. Sorry. And then you can check out, you know, then you can go to Bar Dog, which most people don't realize that Bar Dog, it's a
fantastic
great bar.
Food.
They have amazing food. They're doing a Cornish game hen with andouille sausage or Rosa Poblano chicken chowder as their appetizer.
Wow.
And then you can choose from a grilled ahi tuna steak or a blue cheese stuffed filet with horseradish mashed potatoes.
And this is for $20.11.
That's $20.11. There are some more casual places that are doing sort of a different option, and you can learn all about it on their website, downtowndiningweek.com. But like Kooky Canuck is doing two people can eat for $20.11.
Oh, that's really,
wow.
That's really
that is great.
You share an appetizer, which their portions are huge, so it's plenty big. And then you each get your choice of an entree. And then Flying Saucer, which has a new menu, which most people, again, think beer. They don't think, let's go there to eat. They're doing pick an entree each and then share a dessert. So you have
great.
A lot of different options, and all the restaurants and their menus are listed on the website.
And this is November the 14th through the 20th, you can hit numerous.
Yep.
I mean, you can hit numerous restaurants.
We have a lot of people that put together supper clubs, and they go to a different place each week, or each night.
That's a great idea.
So it's a lot of fun, and they all blog about it and tweet about it. So it's a great place. We have some great Asian options, too. You can go out of the box if you want to with Bangkok Alley and Thai Bistro.
Both great.
Mm-hmm. So tell me about this Magic Kids Martinis and much more.
I know.
I love this concept.
On 11-11-11. Playhouse has a fundraiser coming up called Curtain Up, and it's a taste of Playhouse. And so from 7 to 11 on November 11th at Playhouse, they're putting on five different parties. Okay, so you can go to a Zydeco Martini Lounge upstairs, or you could hang out in the country jazzy grassy tonk for beer tasting and sliders at another part of Playhouse. They also have a speakeasy vaudeville party going on if you're into that. They also have a Jello shot hop. The Magic Kids, the band, is going to perform at. So there's five different bands, five different parties, five different kind of things going on.
And if you've not been to this venue, it is magnificent.
Beautiful.
It's really gorgeous, and I'm so proud of them and so proud of Memphis for getting it. Chris and I just had a wonderful experience there this weekend.
Yeah, with Indie Memphis.
Oh, my goodness. The best event of the year.
And what a great marriage, a Playhouse
Absolutely.
And Indie Memphis.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
it was wonderful, and I'm so excited about all of these collaborations. And Playhouse is, if you haven't gone, you've got to go. Mm-hmm. I mean, not only do they do great plays and great events, but the venue is just gorgeous.
It is. And this is going to be a fun way to explore it, because you'll get to kind of go all through it, which isn't always the case if you show up to a theater show.
They've been doing this event for several years now, and it really seems like they're distilling it and sort of perfecting it.
Yeah.
So, you know, to see, you know, the wall of sound enthusiasts, Magic
yes,
Kids,
right, exactly.
up top, a Red Bull Jello shot party,
yeah.
while underneath the stage
yes.
in the password speakeasy.
Yes. You know, right. They play with play money in the casinos.
Isn't that cute?
Yeah.
And if people, Black Max is one of those great local bands that probably doesn't get the publicity they deserve. They mix a lot of sort of vaudeville and cabaret with just this soaring rock and roll. They are a whole lot of fun.
Well, it sounds like a great time.
Does that sound fun?
Tell me about It's the Little Things.
It's the Little Things. It's this great art show that we're doing. There's a lot of different events tied to Downtown Dining Week. So you'll see events all throughout the week. We're doing a show at the Majestic Grill. It's an art opening for Mary Padrone and Susan Copeland. And they wanted to put together an art show that was affordable art, especially in time for the holidays here.
I love that.
Yeah, it's gonna allow people that, you know, maybe have a new house or a new apartment that can't afford to go to a gallery and purchase a $1,200 piece of art, but they can purchase a $95 piece of art and have an original piece of art on their wall.
And you hit it. It's the time that everybody's going out and thinking about buying those gifts for the holidays. So that's perfect.
Exactly. It's beautiful. There's abstract pieces. There's some more realistic pieces, but they're all beautiful, real colorful. We're doing an opening reception for them at the Majestic Grill on Wednesday, November 16th from 6 to 8. We'll have wine and beer and hors d'oeuvres for everybody. But the show will be up all through November and December through the first week in January.
And that's at the Majestic.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, tell me about our favorite guy, Breeze Kayal.
Breeze is going to be performing at Felicia Suzanne's on Thursday, November 17th from 7 to 9. She's going to have some live music out there. He's going to be playing cocktails. If you've never been to Felicia's patio, you really need to go.
It's gorgeous. Mm-hmm. It's on Main Street.
Beautiful. And if you think it's going to be too cold for an outdoor event, it's tucked between the Madison Hotel and her restaurant, which is in Brinkley Plaza. And so it's very cordoned off, and you're not getting that breeze that goes down. Well, you are getting breeze, but not that breeze that goes down Main Street. So you can check that out. It's beautiful.
And another fun thing that I personally adore is Flip the Lights Mm-hmm. Or is it Flip the Switch?
Flip the Switch Party. What Downtown Memphis Commission has done a great job this year. They've eliminated the holiday parade, which I'm a little sad about. But what they've
done is
they've taken all that money. It costs a whole heck of
it
a
does,
lot to put
a lot
on a
of
parade
energy and effort.
And so they've taken all that money and they've put it into lights for Downtown Memphis. So downtown, we started with the light committee a couple years ago, and we were all climbing up our own ladders and decorating the light poles. Which I am so glad not to have to do that this year.
I'm glad you're not too.
Yes, but it's going to be amazing lights. So the lights are going to be different. It's really going to make downtown a holiday destination this
year. So now
year.
You can get on the trolley and tour all of the lights mm-hmm. and visit the venues. And this event is
It's going to be the 18th. Again, it's part of Downtown Dining Week, 4:30 to 6. There's going to be carolers and hot cocoa and all sorts of fun going on. They always do a great job. So just bring the kids, come out, check out the lights, kick off the holiday season.
Well, while I got you, tell me about Cocktails in the Round.
Cocktails in the Round. We are doing Michael Hughes, who is local sommelier and wine manager at Joe's. Mm-hmm. He and I have put together this new event that we're hoping to make probably an every other month event where we're bringing together local bartenders in sort of a competition environment.
So this is a competition, not an exhibition.
No, this is a competition. For this event, since it is part of Downtown Dining Week, it's going to be four different downtown bartenders that are going to compete to make the award-winning cocktail out of a surprise ingredient. So they'll be given a list of potential ingredients. Prior to that, we'll have a generic bar set up in the center. I'm emceeing, so if you want to come out and harass me, please do.
Well, that sounds like so much fun, and the cocktails are included in the admission price.
Yeah, it's only $15. You get to taste four different cocktails, so it's really a good deal. Yeah. You know, there'll be smaller portions, but it'll be really probably the equivalent of two cocktails.
And that's at 145 South Main downtown. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
That's great. Chris, tell me about the Sondheim concert.
A Sondheim celebration at Theater Memphis. Stephen Sondheim is, I think, inarguably the greatest living composer for the musical theater, and his works are immediately recognizable to people who don't even like musicals. and his legacy stretches back. I mean, you know, he worked with Leonard Bernstein on West Side Story. Mm-hmm. He worked on A Funny Thing Happened to the Way the Forum. He worked on Gypsy. He does all of these collaborative efforts. But then he comes into his own with shows like
Into the Woods.
Into the Woods, like with Sweeney Todd, yeah. With Merrily We Roll Along, Follies, Company, right. Anyone Can Whistle. I'm leaving out big ones. Assassins.
Yeah, Assassins.
I was having a conversation. People were coming up with their favorite Sondheim songs, and the song Unworthy of Your Love from Assassins came to mind. I mean, who else but Sweeney Todd? But Stephen Sondheim could imagine this gorgeous duet between Squeaky Fromm and John Hinckley, you know? He just has this great sense of melody, a very wicked sense of humor, and it's just throughout his body of work. Mm-hmm. So this concert that's in the Little Theater at Theater Memphis, the Next Stage, sorry, I'm old and I forget that it's not the Little Theater sometimes. It's a compilation of all, from every period of his work.
Well, that
compiled by Bennett Wood, who has a long history of working.
And that's through November the 20th?
Yes.
At Theater Memphis Next Stage. Stephanie, tell me about the Nutcracker Children's Tea.
The Nutcracker Children's Tea. It's going to be so great. Everyone has to go to this. It's November 20th at the Peabody Hotel, and it's a tea party with the cast of the Nutcracker. It's wonderful.
And it's called Journey to the Kingdom of the Sweets. How cute is that?
It's great. They can make cupcakes. They can meet the cast. It's going to be wonderful.
And the gingerbread houses will probably be done by then.
I think so.
Yeah.
There's games. There's activities. They meet the characters. They get to have tea. And, I mean, how cool is that? And it's in conjunction with the Nutcracker.
It is.
I think it's really cool. The Nutcracker is going to be at the Orpheum December the 2nd through the 4th. And this is the first time in 15 years that the ballet and the Memphis Symphony will perform together.
Yeah. So, it's going to be a wonderful. And you can actually get discount tickets early if you go to the Nutcracker Tea.
Well, there you go.
$45.
And then also, they have the Nutcracker K-12 school matinee at the Orpheum, the first and the second.
Yes.
Tracy, tell me about the Creative Aging Artists Showcase.
Sure, the Creative Aging Artists Showcase. The Creative Aging is a great nonprofit that sends performers and artists into senior centers and does work with senior citizens. And so they are having a fundraiser at the Great Hall and Conference Center, 6 to 10 on, I forget the date.
It's coming on the 12th.
Okay, November 12th. And Ruby Wilson's going to perform, Joyce Cobb, The Masqueraders. Lots of wonderful performers, and it's a benefit for Creative Aging in their efforts to bring the arts to senior citizens.
And they also have a buffet-style dinner with a fajita bar, a pasta bar, smoothie bar, and a cash bar. What other kind of bar would you want?
I don't know.
I think that's covered them all. Okay, Chris, everybody's favorite, the Pixies. Coming to the Orpheum.
Do we really need to say anything else?
The Pixies are coming to the Orpheum.
All right, they break up in like 92,
yes,
93,
right.
And all of my friends are beside themselves.
Right, right.
And I guess I was beside myself too, sad. But then you get Frank Black, Black Francis, you know, he puts out the Teenager of the Year record, The Breeders, is Kim and Kelly Deal.
Yep.
They put out Cannonball. And they were just different enough to be interesting, but just alike enough to scratch that Pixies itch. So it was like, yay, we get two Pixies. But then in 2004, they get back together, and I was like a teenager again. It was supposed to just be for like this one brief tour, and they've pretty much been touring since. Mm-hmm.
This is November the 14th at the Orpheum. Also, I have to say, this sounds like such a cool event. Maximus Elevenus,
yes,
is going to be at the Warehouse, which is at 93 South GE Patterson. Fans of the mock documentary, This Is Spinal Tap, have designated 11/11 as Nigel Tufnel Day. And this event is going to be so much fun. You can find your inner rock star, come dressed as a rock star, or you can just wear your rock gear. There's going to be entertainment by El Dorado and the Ruckus and a DJ. There, you will be able to show your skills on Guitar Hero and go head-to-head with other rock gods. There will be a celebrity karaoke that you can join.
Will there be a very small Stonehenge?
A very small Stonehenge. And you can also pose your heart out in the rock booth, the rock photo booth. And of course, This Is Spinal Tap will be shown. That sounds like so much fun. Denny, tell me about the 5th anniversary interim celebration.
Yeah, Interim Restaurant, it's hard to believe it's their 5th anniversary. Mm. And, you know, Jackson, Kramer's back, Chef Jackson is back, so it's kind of come full circle. They're doing a series of wine dinners to celebrate their 5th anniversary. And one really cool thing that they're doing is if you come to these wine dinners, it enters you for a chance to win a trip to Napa.
Oh, wow.
That Interim will pay for.
You just go to the celebration and put your name in the hat and have a chance to win.
You can go to the
and
website.
And they're
going to
draw for it that night?
There's a series of wine dinners. I think once the wine dinners are all over,
then they'll go ahead and
notify the winner. But you have to attend one of the wine dinners to win. But it should be great.
Good excuse
to go get some great food by Jackson if you haven't been back since he's gotten back into town. It's been fantastic. And a good way to congratulate them on their 5th anniversary. That's a really big deal for restaurants to make it to 5 years. It's a hard business. And the 5th year kind of is that sort of, we've made it.
That sounds like a fun thing. Also, mm-hmm. Tell us about the upcoming classes that you have at the Metal Museum.
We have new classes. They're for beginners. We have a bronze bowl casting class, and that's actually the same day as our holiday open house on December 11th. And you can make a bronze bowl as a gift for someone, or you could make one with your own patterns. You basically design it, and we cast it for you that day.
Wow. And the class sizes are limited, so
yes.
Please go ahead and sign up if you're interested.
Yes.
Also, tell me about the Blacksmith Friday.
Blacksmith Friday is the Metal Museum's version of Black Friday. It's the day after Thanksgiving, and we have sales in the gift store and the museum store, as well as blacksmiths doing demonstrations, and our Master Metalsmith show is still up.
And with every $100 purchase, you get a free gift.
You mean Like this one?
Yay! I love
presents.
Yes. Can I open it now?
Yes, of course.
If you haven't ever been to the Metal Museum shop, I do my Christmas shopping there every year.
I do too.
There's jewelry and Christmas ornaments and Christmas ornament stuff.
Beautiful. Oh, that's beautiful. Now, this was made by an artist at the Metal Museum.
Yes, Jeannie made those, and they will be the free gift if you spend $100 either that day or that weekend, either online or in the store. Then we
that's
will give
gorgeous.
You one of those.
That's gorgeous. Wonderful. Okay, we've talked about Bronze Bowl. We've talked about Blacksmith Friday. Let's talk about new restaurants.
Yeah, we've got a great new restaurant opening up downtown. It just opened up 2 weeks ago. It's called Blue. It is in the Westin Hotel, which is down right by FedEx Forum, right by Gibson there. They do valet parking. I'm real excited about this. I had the chance to meet the chef, Chef Robert, and his wife the other day. They have already become the most enthusiastic Memphians.
I love that.
They are fantastic. He's an amazing chef. They've moved here from Rhode Island, and they are just loving Memphis. They love the opportunities here. They love the food culture here. They have been going to a lot of different events and really getting acquainted with the city. The restaurant itself is beautiful. They have an amazing bar, really neat, interesting, fun cocktails.
And what's the address?
The address, it's in the Westin. So okay. It's in the Westin. If you just go to the Westin, the address is 221 South 3rd Street. But if you just come down, they have valet parking, and it's free with the restaurant.
Is it French-inspired fare, I assume, with the name?
It's actually, you know, they study the name. I think it has more to do with blue, as in blues, but they wanted to spell it differently. but they do have, you know, they have lamb lollipops on the appetizer menu. They have a lot of fun stuff.
And who knew?
And his and heritage
guess, we're
is,
out of town. We're out of town, and we're out of time. Thank you, guys. Go out and enjoy your local color and come back and see us next week.
Sounds good, but it's good. He's a sweetheart. You guys should go check out his food.
I drove past it the other
day. It's
delicious. I didn't realize it was ready yet.
Now, what was the name of the one that was
there before? Was Soul.
What happened?
Yeah. Their contract was up.